New voices in the Kenosha casino debate were sounding off at the state capitol today. Supporters and opponents of the $800 million project held separate events. The Menominee tribe is behind this project. Seven members of the tribe spoke, and that group included two 10-year-old students who were chosen by their principal to write and read statements. They talked about how the casino will help bring the tribe out of poverty. On the other side, some conservative activist leaders from other parts of the nation talked about how it will cost Wisconsin jobs. Tonight, we have both sides.
There are all sorts of business models out there for Indian tribes to use to build their economies without going in this model and doing it organically and, frankly, much more stably for them.
We want this to be treated fairly so that we have a decent homes, good health care, and better schools. I also realize the Kenosha project will create many jobs for the people who live in the Kenosha area.
We tried to focus. Governor Walker has to sign off on the project, and during a stop in Milwaukee today, he didn't give any hints about when a decision might be made.
I'm legally under no obligation to act quickly on this. The Bureau of Indian Affairs took almost 20 years on this. I'm certainly not going to take that, but we're going to take the time necessary to make a good decision.
In the past, the governor has said that every Wisconsin tribe needs to support this casino. Right now, the Ho-Chunk and Potawatomi are opposed, saying it will harm them financially.